हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, नाउ टुडे माय टॉपिक फॉर दिस वीडियो इज क्लास 10th चैप्टर 1 रियल नंबर्स। नाउ डियर स्टूडेंट्स, यू हैव इन क्लास 9th यू बिगेन योर एक्सप्लोरेशन ऑफ द वर्ल्ड ऑफ रियल नंबर्स एंड एनकाउंटर्ड रैशनल नंबर्स देयर। लेट अस कंटिन्यू आवर डिस्कशन ऑन रियल नंबर्स। वी बिगिन विद द टू वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ पॉजिटिव इंटीजर्स। अंडर दिस फर्स्ट प्रॉपर्टी, नाउ व्हाट आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू टुडे, टू वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ पॉजिटिव इंटीजर्स। फर्स्ट प्रॉपर्टी अंडर दिस इज यूक्लिड्स, इट इज यूक्लिड्स डिवीजन, Euclid's division algorithm, and second very important property of positive integer under this topic is fundamental theorem of arithmetic. Now, as the name suggests, Euclid division algorithm has to do with the divisibility of positive integers. Whereas fundamental theorem of arithmetic has to do something with multiplication of positive integers. Here also integers. So today what we are going to discuss, we are discussing here two very important properties of positive integers. Under this first one is Euclid division algorithm. As the name suggests, it will deal with the divisibility of positive integers, whereas fundamental theorem of arithmetic has to do something with the multiplication of positive integers. Now today I will focus on the topic here, fundamental theorem of arithmetic, with examples and two questions here, very important questions, and I hope you will enjoy this. First of all, what is the meaning of fundamental theorem of arithmetic? What does it mean? Let us see here, fundamental theorem of arithmetic. According to statement, first of all, fundamental theorem of arithmetic, according to its statement, every composite number can be expressed, that is factorized, as a product of primes, and this factorization is unique apart from the order in which the prime factors occur. For example, here I have a number. Now, one more thing before discussing the example, I will tell you one more thing. Due to its uniqueness, factorization is unique, means factors will remain same apart from the order may change, prime factors ka jo order hai that may change, but factors will remain same. Due to this uniqueness, this fundamental theorem of arithmetic is also known as unique factorization theorem. That is, what does it means? It means every composite number is equal to product of primes. For example, first number I am taking here, number 6. This is your example. For example, if I am taking number 6, factors of 6 are 2 into 3. Rather, I should say prime factors of 6 is equal to 2 into 3. Now next is prime factors of one more number I am taking here. Let us see here number 96. Let us take number 96. If I factorize 96 here, 96, I can find out the factors here. 2 ones are 2, 2 fours are 8, 2 eights are 16. Similarly, 2 twos are 4, 2 fours are 8. Also, 2 ones are 2, 2 twos are 4. Then 2 sixes are 12. Then we have here 2 threes are 6 and 3 ones are 3. Now this can be written as how many 2s are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 2 raised to the power 5 multiplied by 3. 3 is coming one time here. Similarly, if I am taking one more example of 404, let us say this number is there. Its factors are 2 into 2 into 101. Now interesting point is this, if factors of a number will remain same, as in the case of 6, factors are 2 and 3 only, order may change. This may be written as 3 into 2. Now similarly, in case of 96, order may change 3 into 2 raised to the power 5, or we can also write down in the form of 2 raised to power 2 into 101, or 101 into 2 raised to the power 2. So what do you understand from this is, factors will remain same, factors are unique, factorization is unique, that's why it is called unique factorization theorem. But order may change. If I am writing down 2 at the first and the second time, ho sakta hai, I may write down the 2 at the second position. Factors ki position change ho sakti hai, but prime factors will remain same for a particular number. This is nothing but fundamental theorem of arithmetic. This is called as fundamental theorem of arithmetic. Now, let us discuss one question related to this property. So I have written one question for you. In that question here, question is check whether 15 raised to the power n can end with the digit 0 for any natural number n. Or we can also see this, check whether 6 raised to the power n can end with the digit 0 for any natural number. So let us see about here. Now these questions are given in NCERT books also. See, these are questions are very, very important. Try to understand these questions here. First of all, let us focus what I have written here. Statement was 15 raised to the power n can end with the digit 0 and 6 raised to the power n can end with the digit 0. First of all, we know that any number ending with 0 must have the factors 2 raised to the power m into 5 raised to the power n as its prime factors. What does it mean? Let us see here. So the number I have taken which are ending with 0, 0, 10, I have taken here 10, 20, 30. So let us find out the factors of 10. Factors of 10 are 2 into 5. Factors of 20 are 2 into 2 into 5. Factors of 30 are 2 into 3 into 5. So what are your observation here? So in the case of 10, we have 2 and 5. In case of 20, we have 2 and 5. In case of 30, we have 2 and 5. Means the number which are ending with the digit 0 must have at least one factor as 2 and one factor as 5 here. So let us consider these questions here. Now question was 15 raised to the power n and 16 raised to the power n. Let us see about these questions here. First of all, the number I have written here 15, and I will write down here the next digit is 6 here. Of course, raised to the power n, raised to the power n, or any natural number n here. Now, first of all, factors of 15 is equal to prime factors of 15 is equal to 3 into 5. Similarly, factors of 6 are 2 into 3. Now, what is your observation here? In 15, prime factors are 3 and 5. So, it is not having 2 as its factor. So, I can write down here, not having 2 as its factor. Similarly, factors of 6 is equal to 2 into 3. So, there must be 1 5 to make it 10. So, it means it is not having which factor? 5 as its factor. So, according to the, you can say, uniqueness of fundamental theorem of arithmetic, 2 is not the prime factor of 15, because according to this theorem, 15 has only two factors, 3 and 5, not 2. Similarly, in case of 6, according to the uniqueness of fundamental theorem of arithmetic, it has two factors, 2 and 3 only, not 5 as its factors. So, 5 here, 2 is not the factor to make it 0, 5 2s are 10. Here, 5 is not the factor, 2 5s are 10 to make it 10 at the last digit here. So, these numbers, what we can say here? No. Answer is no. 15 raised to the power n. And n means, let me explain this again. No, 15 raised to the power n and 16 raised to the power n can never end with digit 0. Now, what do you mean by here n? N is any natural number here. N belongs to any natural number, 1, 2, 3, so on. What does it mean? It means 15 raised to the power 1, 15 raised to the power 2, 15 raised to the power 3, and so on. But we know that 15 has only two factors, 3 and 5. When we are trying to write down this 15 raised to the power n here, it means factors of 15, prime factors of 15 are 3 into 5 raised to the power n, factors will remain same. Similarly, in the case of 6 raised to the power n, factors will remain same, 2 into 3 raised to the power n, same. Means power of, you can say 15 and 6 may be any, but factors will remain same. According to which theorem? According to the fundamental theorem of arithmetic, according to the uniqueness of fundamental theorem of arithmetic, factors will remain same. There will be not any change there. So, in 15, there is no 2 as a factor. In 6, there is no 5 as a factor. So, these numbers can never end with the digit 0. So, this is all about this theorem with these examples. I hope you have now understood this topic very much clear. Thank you.